Wolverine has had a long ongoing romance with Tragedy, and along the way, a lot of his romantic partners have also ended up getting tangled up in it. Join me as we count down our top 10 love interests of Wolverine. Number 10, Mystique. Wolverine has been around for a long time, so it's no surprise that this is a love interest I constantly forget about, but that exists. Mystique has of course also been around for a long time, and is possibly even older than Wolverine. So of course at some point in these characters' history, they had to have worked together and, of course, slept together. When it comes to Wolverine and Mystique, these two actually go way back, all the way back to the Wild Wild West. It was then that Logan and Raven seemingly first met, and even teamed up together. It could have been them against the world, but of course, what usually happens with Raven when it comes to romance also happened during her time with Wolverine. Ultimately, Raven betrayed Logan, putting herself first, and it was because of this that the two ended things, and on a pretty sour note. She also ended things by kicking him out of a moving train car, so yeah. Logan's memory isn't always the greatest, but something that he wouldn't soon forget was how untrustworthy Mystique was. Even to this day, he's like, "You suck, Mystique. Also, you're gonna be lonely because you're always betraying everyone." Number 9, Maureen. She might not be from the main continuity, but Maureen had such a profound and life-changing effect on Old Man Logan that even after she and their children together were tragically murdered by the Hulk gang, Old Man Logan never once forgot about her. He even later asks a returned loved, Mariko, to look out for Maureen, who herself, after more than a lifetime of tragedy and literally going to hell and back, is finally trying to live a normal and peaceful life. Mariko, that is, not Maureen, who is dead and in Old Man Logan's timeline. Old Man Logan set aside some money so that Mariko could keep an eye on younger Maureen and ideally try to protect her moving forward, as he knew that if her life continued the way it had in his timeline, it would end in tragedy. He was like, "I just love her so much, I just want her to be okay." And friends, before we move on to this next spot, if you are loving this list and you want even more Wolverine love interests, I'm pretty sure I could do 10 more. There's a lot of them out there. Be sure to let us know that you love this list by giving it a thumbs up. Can't give it a thumbs down, because that doesn't exist anymore, so just thumbs up, please. What a world we live in where we can't dislike things. Number 8, Rose O'Hara. Rose was Wolverine's first love, and for most of his life was seemingly unrequited. In the Marvel Noir universe, she is also one of his main love interests. Rose is probably the reason why Wolverine tends to have a thing for redheads, actually, although that might be a foggier part of his memory, and he might not always remember that. Honestly, at this point, I'm surprised that Logan can even remember what day it is or what his phone number is without having it written down somewhere. That's just how much he's had his brain and his memory scrambled. Rose was brought in from town to be a companion to young James Howlett, aka Kid Wolverine, when he was growing up on his parents' estate. Also, just to be clear, he wasn't known as Kid Wolverine, but you know, we know him as Wolverine now, so he was a kid. You know what I'm saying. Rose was also tasked with looking after James, as he was known for being a weak and often sickly child. Rose died tragically when she ended up trying to get involved in a fight between Logan and his childhood rival, who had returned years later, Dog. It was implied then, as she lay dying, that she perhaps also did have feelings for James at some point. Wow, what a time to find that out. Unlike many of Wolverine's other love interests, Rose has not yet returned from the dead. At least, not yet, anyways. Maybe later, who knows. A lot of them do, a lot of them come back to life. Number 7, Yukio. Yukio has been both a lover and a friend to Wolverine, as well as acted as the adopted mother of his adopted daughter, Emiko. Yukio first met Wolverine during her time working as an assassin for Clan Yashida. Initially, she was Wolverine's enemy, as she actually worked for the head of the clan, Lord Shinjin, who wanted to shame and kill Logan. Yukio would develop an attraction to Wolverine, but at the time, he was basically hung up on Mariko Yashida, the daughter of Lord Shinjin, so nothing came of it. However, it was because of her feelings for Wolverine that Yukio would ultimately decide to help save Mariko's life later on, despite the fact that Mariko was kind of like her romantic rival for Logan's affections. Yukio is also known for being close friends with Storm and a possibly implied romantic interest of Aurora's as well. At least that's how I see it. I feel like maybe not everybody sees those implications. But I don't know, I think I would ship Storm and Yukio, just like I would also ship Wolverine and Yukio. And just like I would also ship Storm and Wolverine. It's a nice little triangle. little love triangle there. Number 6, Silver Fox. Silver Fox has become a complicated character since her original story as Wolverine's lover. Silver Fox is a member of the Blackfoot tribe and is Canadian. When Wolverine met her, she had recently been widowed and as such began a relationship with Logan, who had recently been accepted into living with her tribe. Silver Fox, however, would tragically die at the hands of Sabretooth, Wolverine's arch nemesis and a vicious man and a vicious mutant. Later on, however, this act would also end up being tied to Romulus, who apparently influenced Sabretooth and did a lot of brainwash shenanigans regarding the memories of her death and who was believed to have been behind it. Wolverine would end up attacking the people of Mount Logan and blaming them for her death because Romulus had him brainwashed to believe that that's what happened, despite Sabretooth having taken credit for killing Silver Fox and doing so in front of Logan. Silver Fox would also later seemingly return, but it's more likely that this version of her associated with Weapon X, Team X, and Hydra was actually some kind of clone or was an agent who was simply brainwashed and manipulated into thinking that she was the true Silver Fox. Yeah, Silver Fox became really complicated, but she used to be very simple. Number 5, Tyger Tiger. One of my favorite of Wolverine's romantic interests has to be Tyger Tiger, who is long known as one of the main crime lords of Madripoor. Before that, she was Jessen Hoan, who ended up being kidnapped by the Reavers and later saved by the X-Men. When Jessen learned that Madripoor crime lord Roche was behind the Reavers' attack, which had pretty much completely uprooted and dramatically altered her life moving forward, she dedicated her life to usurping and defeating him, taking up the mantle Tyger Tiger, or taking up the name Tyger Tiger, really, that's how we know her now. Wolverine would later learn of Tiger's true identity as Jessen Hoan and would pledge himself to her cause, eventually working as her personal bodyguard while in his patch persona. During this time, Wolverine would also become a somewhat casual lover to Tiger as the two continued to grow closer together. And I love them together, I just think they're so cute. Number 4, Itsu. Itsu was Wolverine's wife at one point many years ago when he was training with the master Bando Saburo. The two fell in love, were married, and Itsu even became pregnant with Logan's child. For a brief time, they were happy, until Logan accidentally stabbed a fellow member of the community with his claws. As a result, he was forced to leave, exiled, but when he went to say goodbye to Itsu, he only found her dead. Years later, it would be revealed the Bucky Barnes as the Winter Soldier was actually the one responsible for her death, seemingly manipulated into killing her under Romulus's orders. Oh, Romulus, pulling all these strings and then just disappearing. Their unborn child was also stolen from Itsu's womb, and due to the child's mutant gene, which would also grant him a healing factor, survived. This child would grow up to be Akahiro, aka Dokken, Wolverine's troublesome son, who was manipulated into thinking his father had killed his mother before abandoning him. And I'll just let you guess who made him believe that. If you can't guess, it was Romulus. Romulus did everything. And also nothing. Number 3, Jean Grey. Despite these two often not ending up together throughout stories told of them across various mediums, the fact remains that Wolverine will likely always carry a torch somewhere for Jeannie. Jean Grey and Wolverine are generally both never in the right place to end up together, and oftentimes their love story, if they do end up having one in whichever canon or narrative that we're talking about here, ends up being tainted with tragedy. The fact remains, however, that both Logan and Jean often count on one another to do what's right, and even turn to one another when they need someone to lean on in a time of need. Even when Jean is dead, Wolverine still has been known to fight for her honor, and when she has been alive, Wolverine has also been the one to kill her more than once. Needless to say, their relationship is way more than complicated. Number 2, Mariko Yashida. At this point, Mariko has had a long and somewhat convoluted story, but initially in the comics she was simply the daughter of Japanese crime lord Shinjin Harada, who ruled over Clan Yashida. Mariko would end up meeting Wolverine when the X-Men asked her brother, the mutant Sunfire, for help. While initially kind of scared of Wolverine, eventually the two would fall for one another, both admiring the differences of the other and also sharing a sense of kindness. Mariko would end up forcibly married off by her father and in a relationship where she was pretty badly mistreated. However, she felt compelled to stay in that marriage due to a sense of honor to her family. Eventually, however, Mariko would become free again and would even take over as the leader of Clan Yashida in her father's place. For a time, her and Wolverine were engaged, with her not wanting to be married until she had removed all the criminal ties from her family. In the end, however, Mariko would die in a criminal gang war before she could end up marrying Logan. Mariko ended up poisoned, and Logan helped her death to be less painful at Mariko's behest by making it a lot more brief. Logan would punish her killer by visiting him every year and slicing off a piece of him until he died. This wouldn't be the end of Mariko's story, though, as she would continue to pop up as the forced tormentor of Wolverine in hell, and later resurrected as Gorgon's Scarlet Samurai. Basically another lover that we just couldn't leave dead, because yeah. I also love when Wolverine comes to hell and is like, alright, I'll free you though, Mariko, and she's like, nah, I'm good. Just remember me as I was. I don't want to go back. Like, what? They could have had a happy ending there. Oh well. Number 1. Storm. Storm has always been a close friend of Wolverine's and is sometimes known for being his romantic partner as well, especially more recently in the comics. Depending on the reality we're talking about, there have also been universes where these two are firmly cemented as a romantic couple. Even in modern comics, with all the history they have shared as teammates, close friends, and romantic interests, these two's chemistry still manages to surface, and even today, they get pretty awesome flirty moments written in for them. Like during the Ten of Swords Otherworld tournament when the two faced off in a drinking contest against one another. The best thing about that, too, was that they both held their own and proved they could match each other. That's the thing about Storm and Wolverine. Both are incredibly strong, both as superheroes and as individuals, which is just a small part of why they work so well together. They're very, like, evenly matched, which I like. Who is your favorite romantic partner for Wolverine? Do you think Wolverine should just stay away from romance altogether and accept a long life of loneliness? How do you feel about all the tragedy both he and his love interests have suffered through their lives? Let us know in the comments below. This has been Top 10 Nerd, and I'm your host, Amanda McKnight. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, you stay nerdy, YouTube.